Like I said, it's just another shockwave, and it comes in handy when you have a bunch of enemies around. Most of the time, I probably won't use really much more than a Light Reaver and a regular Soul Reaver. Go through there and 20. Alright, there we go. Now, here is the Dark Reaver Temple. As you could already have seen, it was too low to jump regular, so yeah, we obviously have to. Okay, now just I'm being a dumbass. Instead of filling up my health, I went ahead and just went into the temple, not thinking about it. So we are gonna go back out and get me some health. Don't matter anyway, this game's full of backtracking. Okay, and there's the thing you can use to charge up your Reaver if you want. We don't really need it, so take on some more shades. Fucking annoying fuckers. Yeah, this I get my ass handed to me. Perfect Carcass is not really a good idea to use against the shades, being that they only take 2 hits anyway. Yet I still keep doing it. Do you take them out? The portal will open. Now I got to charge my Reaver. In case any enemies want to pop out of nowhere and beat the shit out of me. I wish it could be as easy as when you died, you went back to the spectral realm and it filled your health up halfway. You always got 2 chances on Soul Reaver and Soul Reaver 2. But that's what made it hard. This is just explaining the whole idea behind the Pillars of Balance. obviously Kane became the new Scion Bounce. Thank God there's... Why did I not just get to health? Oh well, there's nice and slow down here. I'm not gonna die. There's a jump pad for King. Thought maybe I could use it, but... Come on, take him out. Soul. Remember in Soul Reaver 1 and 2, this would give you full health when you were in the spirit realm. It wouldn't matter how much health you had as long as you devoured one soul. Always trying to try to take one slow out at a time. Because if you take two out, the one's just going to devour the other one. And I think I'll show you that here. Right there. And he just comes back. See, they just keep coming back. Now we need to find a conduit. And you can climb up there. Not in the spirit realm. See, it's been a while since I've played this game again, so... I'm still trying to get the controls down and remember what the fuck I was doing. Sound seems like it's getting a little bit better. And if anybody can help me out and figure out how to get Frapp's counter to stop showing up in the corner, that would be real nice. Leave a comment. See, there's a good display of what the true power of the Reaver's Blast is. Being that I hate fighting these things anyway. Guys, I don't think I take them on. I'm hitting the action button. Just grab the Reaver. Charged with the elemental power of darkness. Now here's where I decide to be an idiot and can't remember where the fuck to go. Health Talisman. Now, I probably won't be 100% run, because like I said, this is basically a blind run. I mean, I've done like one practice file, but that's it. And then I lost that file too, so... Anything after that is going to be... blind. See, I go up here and I don't even realize why I did that. Go back, you never opened the portal. there's the two pieces that I need to do. I need to go back to the room and become a person in the material room. Past it. I don't see how that's a grave, but if you notice, it's a little symbol of the Darkness River, though. Go back, stupid. It's right there. What are you doing? See, this is why I hate getting lost. I guess I was looking for things. What the hell did I go back to the spirit realm for? Yeah, I'm still trying to get the controls down for this, and changing reverbs is a pain in the neck. One and two. Portals back up, and we'll make our way back into the real world instead of this stupid altar temple, whatever you want to call it. Change back to the regular Reaver, because if you notice, the Dark Reaver makes you lose health. And we aren't going to fight these guys, we're just going to go back through. And now we have gargoyle statues. Or crows, whatever you want to call them. Hence the Charge Reaver. Like I said, I'll show you what the Darkness Reaver does now. Charge up the Reaver. Go down here, wait for the thing to disappear, change to the Darkness, and voila, we're invisible. Nope, can't get out that way. Use a regular Reaver. Now it's going to show us the way that we got to go now. If I'm not mistaken, I still get lost trying to find that way. Well, what do you know? It's back at the beginning where we turned into the material realm. We're going to just go through here. No, instead I go back to where we're supposed to go later. Moving too fast there, Raphael. Okay, we'll skip these guys. There's another health talisman. I guess that makes two. Get off of auto face. Well, I guess I do fight him. There's so many fights in this thing, I don't even remember which ones I fight and which ones I ignore. Now the sorcerers, I hate fighting these. If you don't do something about them, like basically spam some kind of move, then all they're gonna do is, what the hell? What the hell is this shit? I get stuck in a glitch, now I can't even get out of the ground? Really? I guess I had to come back and do this all over again. We'll see you guys when we get back to the same spot.